got the MacBook Air here. MacBook Air with M1 chip. I've been using it for a couple of weeks. First off, I think it's fantastic. I think it's probably Apple's most clear-cut winner of a product that I've probably ever reviewed.
Oh, wow.
I had a lot of reservations about them switching to this M1. I feel like everyone probably had a lot of reservations about them switching to this M1 chip before they actually did it. There were issues that, well, people said there were going to be issues about app compatibility, about so kind of your regular apps wouldn't work. No one was going to update their apps for to work on this Apple Silicon. But yeah, you know, kind of after using it for a week, I think that it could probably change budget. It's not really a budget laptop, but kind of sub £1,000 laptops forever. The performance is kind of on par with far more expensive machines. It's Geekbench results, kind of single core performance towers over any other laptop from Apple. Battery life is amazing, full day with no issues. The MacBook Air has no fan, so no noise, perfectly silent. I kind of use a MacBook Pro for work every day, and kind of the fan just is constant. And you know, I've even though the M1 MacBook Pro does have a fan, kind of what I read about it looks like, again, that fan makes very little noise.
Yeah. You mentioned the Geekbot Bench 5 benchmark tests, and you shared them with me, and I was expecting a big performance jump, but I didn't expect it to be so high. So I've got right now the Dell XPS 13 with Intel's 11th gen Tiger Lake processor. So it's kind of one of the Intel's cutting edge mobile processors. And that got about like 5,485, so like mid 5,000s. Yeah. I've also got Lenovo IdeaPad Slim 7, and that's got Ryzen 7 4800U. So again, this is one of AMD's top notch ultrabook processors, and that scored like 5,260. So both Intel and AMD's latest are floating around the mid 5,000s. You did the benchmark test, same conditions for the MacBook Air M1 chip, and the score was over 7,000, which just shows you like that's a significant jump compared to those two.
And that performance, you know, kind of obviously that's just the synthetic benchmark, but in real world use, you know, that performance is there, both in the CPU, in the graphics. I've got the 8 gig of RAM model, so kind of instead of just keeping the RAM in one area in this new chip, the RAM goes everywhere, so it's unified RAM, so each portion of the chip can kind of use that RAM. And even, you know, 8 gig of RAM doesn't sound that much. I've not run into any issues with RAM. The GPU is fantastic. Kind of a niche example, but I've been running the new version of Football Manager 2021. It's the only game I play on Steam, really. But it seems a good example because I was trying it out on my partner's MacBook Air. I think it's last year's model. And Football Manager gives you this kind of 5-star rating for your GPU. On that model, it's kind of 0.5 star out of 5. And on this MacBook Air, it's 5 out of 5. So basically that's saying that, you know, that's ideal, and everything just runs so well. It's just so fast. It opens, apps open like they would do on a phone. The laptop opens from sleep, kind of as a phone would do. And yeah, it kind of feels like a transformative experience using these new chips.
Yep. And Intel and AMD have been championing their like integrated graphics recently for like laptops. Like, you don't need a graphics card to do entry-level video editing or gaming. And then it looks like, at least Apple claims that this, the integrated graphics is even more powerful than what they're offering. So I guess you'd be able to do 4K editing with a MacBook Air, what before wouldn't really be an option.
Yeah, you know, I mean, Final Cut Pro has been updated for the M1 chip. Adobe's video editing stuff, Premiere Pro and stuff, even though they've not been updated, they still seem to run very well. Photoshop runs excellently. Lightroom runs fantastically well. So yeah, you know, having spent a week with it, it does feel like there's very little bad about this move.
With ARM architecture, I think the biggest issue usually is app compatibility, because Windows 10 doesn't play nice with ARM architecture. It limits what apps you can use. It also, some apps won't use the, won't be optimized, let's say. So like everyday apps you'll use won't run as fast on an ARM Windows laptop, even though it's just as powerful as an Intel accepted thing.
Yeah.
Obviously we're not on Windows 10 with a MacBook, we're on Mac OS. So have you seen those issues? Is Apple doing enough to stop those problems?
So there are kind of a number of different ways that apps can be run in this on this chip. So you've got the apps that have been completely updated to be native to the M1. So there are kind of a few apps that I've tried out that have done this already. There's a version of Photoshop that's built for M1. There's a version of Chrome already from Google that's built specifically for the M1. There's also, it's the first chip on a laptop from Apple that can run iPad and iPhone apps. So you've got that as well. They're a bit rubbish because they're obviously, they're majorly built for touch. Lots of apps don't appear at all. So Netflix, kind of those things don't appear, on Instagram, whatever. And then there are apps that are built for Intel's x86 platform, which are then translated by an app that Apple's built called Rosetta 2. Apple first introduced the Rosetta when it moved away from PowerPCs to the Intel architecture, and it's kind of bringing it back here again. The first time you boot up an M1 MacBook, you'll download this kind of Rosetta app. It's not really an app, it just kind of runs in the background. And then every time you open a app that's built for x86, it will translate the app and then it will run it in kind of an emulated, translated state. I've not noticed any issues with any of these apps. I've not noticed any apps that don't work. I've not noticed any apps that feel sluggish or slower. The only thing I did notice was the first time you open up an app that translates, you'll notice kind of a 30 seconds or so while the system translates that app. And then it seems fine.
Oh, great. Well, that's a bit really good to hear, especially after all the issues I've seen with Windows PCs.
But, you know, there are some things about these laptops that you kind of feel that Apple could have done a little bit more. They kind of look the same as the previous models.
Yeah. So, I was hoping that the rumors were true that Apple's going to redesign the MacBooks, because if you compare it to one of my favorite laptops right now, the Galaxy S13, it's got like almost edge-to-edge screen, hardly any bezel. And Apple prides itself on the designs of its products. So you'd assume Apple would be following soon, and we thought it would be the perfect time now. Yeah. But no, they stick to the same design. It's not, I wouldn't say it's bad looking, they're still good looking apps.
Yeah, you know, they're still really good looking, but we've seen them before.
Exactly, we've seen them before. They're not they're one of the best in the market. So, but I think it's coming. I think, maybe, I don't know, there's been a lot of things happening this year. Maybe that have been delays, or maybe we just want to wait for the time to, because like laptops usually gradually upgrade the series, so you'll have processor refreshes at one point, and then 6 months later you get design refresh, and the cycle continues. So I think maybe next year.
So the MacBook Air, MacBook Pro, and the Mac Mini, Apple's three first Apple Silicon M1 chip-based computers. They're all available to now. Loads more about it on the site. We'll have full reviews of all those products coming very soon. And yeah, hopefully next year we'll see kind of an iMac with an M1 or an M2. And yeah, we'll see kind of how Apple moves away from kind of its its more affordable range to its more pro-level laptops. And it'll be interesting to see kind of how the M chips work with those. Yeah, very exciting times ahead, I think. So yeah, thanks everyone for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.